Next, we're going to look at what's the second most common type of protein domain, and these are the protein domains that consist only of beta strands. According to connectivity and adjacency of these beta strands, there's really three different motifs that the beta strands can pack into. It can either pack into what's known as a beta barrel domain, or it can pack into the Greek key barrel, or the jelly roll barrel. And again, these are all classified, as we'll see, according to the topology diagrams. Let's start with the up and down beta barrel. The up and down beta barrel is really a chemical container, and if you just follow from the N-terminus to the C-terminus, you can see that it's a strand followed by a beta turn. The beta turn is that tight turn that we talked about in one of our previous webcasts that turns into a beta strand, loops around again with a very tight beta turn, and forms alternating or anti-parallel beta sheet structures. Once again, the sheet comes back and loops onto itself to form a completely closed cylinder kind of structure. These tend to be used for receptors of proteins. They're basically, in this case, the interior of the barrel usually has some space that can accommodate a guest molecule. Here's the retinol binding protein. It binds the structure retinol, which is shown there. And you can see the beta strands, they come in pairs. They're paired up so you have this very long yellow strand connected to another very long yellow strand and then some shorter strands. And so all of the beta strands, there are eight of them in the beta barrel, tend to come together in pairs. Now we were looking at a side view, and here's a view down the barrel axis, and you can see it's not perfectly round, it's got this oblong shape to it, but nonetheless it looks like it forms the cylinder of a barrel. Let's take a look at what are the hydrophobic segments. As you might guess, in the interior of that barrel is going to be hydrophobic segments, and here you can see in the blue structure is actually the molecule of retinol, and the hydrophobic amino acids are colored white. The polar hydrophilic amino acids are colored red. So that's down, looking down that barrel axis. It's a similar view as to what you see over here. And now let's take a look at how that interior looks. So here we're going to carve away the interior from a side view, and you can see as we've sliced through this barrel that we can see the retinol molecule that fits snugly into a compartment inside that barrel that's carved out by the amino acid side chains that fill that interior space. The Greek key barrel has a topology that is reminiscent of the ancient Greek key pattern. You've probably seen this pattern decorating walls, and the reason that we name this motif, the Greek key barrel, is because if you look at the adjacency of strands that appear, then they're following the exact same pattern that show up in this Greek key motif. So strand 1 is connected to strand 2 and 4, and so the way that works is that if you just follow the connectivity, 1 is connected to 2 is connected to 3, but then there's a long loop region that comes back to strand 4, which is adjacent to strand number 1. If we look, Greek key barrel is actually important in the islands protein. It's a protein that's actually forms a very large volume fraction of the islands. It helps to adjust the optical properties of the islands, but you can see from the person with the cataract that there has been degradation of that islands protein, and they begin to aggregate together and form large objects that ends up scattering light, and that's the gist of what a cataract is. Well, let's follow the connectivity that you see in this three-dimensional diagram, starting with the N-terminus, and then you notice that the strand number 1 is connected to 2, and it was adjacent to strand number 2 and strand number 4. So how does that look? Well, the other thing to notice is actually in this Greek key barrel domain of the islands protein, there are actually two Greek key motifs. They're colored red and green. And so let's look at the topology diagram and let's look at what's adjacent to one another in space. We can see that strand 3 is actually adjacent to strand 8 as it forms this circular part of the barrel. So the drawing out the topology diagram, we would put strand 3 anti-parallel to strand 8, that's the adjacency. And then if we just go what's next to 3, well, it's 2 followed by 1 followed by 4. So if we start from the other direction, we see that strand 8 is next to 5, which is next to 6, and they're all anti-parallel. That's the adjacency, and that comes by examining what's next to what in this three-dimensional diagram. What about connectivity? Well, there you just start at the N-terminus, that's going to be strand 1, and now we see that this is a Greek key motif. 1 is connected to 2, is connected to 3, and then 3 is what loops back all the way over to strand 4 and makes that anti-parallel to strand number 1. We can see that strand 4 is what joins together the two different Greek key motifs. There's the connectivity. We've got to connect strand 4 to strand 5, and so the C-terminus of strand 4 must connect to the N-terminus of strand 5. And so there's the long loop that comes over there. 5 is connected to 6, is connected to 7, and that loops over to 8. That's our second Greek key motif. The last of the beta structures is known as the jelly roll barrel, and the reason for this is you can kind of see how it looks like we've kneaded the dough that would be used to form a jelly roll, how it's kneaded and woven back and forth. And you should be able to, I won't go through it in detail, starting from this three-dimensional structure of the jelly roll motif with the N-terminus positioned here, go through and find that the adjacency and connectivity looks like this kneaded bread dough of a jelly roll pastry.